The Killer Landlord. There was a man named James Anderson, who lived with his wife in East Ferriby. James Anderson was a very aggressive man, who despised his wife a lot. The gallows was the last thing James Anderson had seen for slaughtering his wife. James and Mary Anderson used to own a pub in the village of Oston Ferry, within the Victorian period. Stress and psychology behind domestic violence was unknown. James Anderson was a concise-tempered man, and he always took out his aggression on Mary Anderson. Things became worse for Mary after the couple moved to the other side of the River Trent to live in East Ferry. Mary would often take the ferry back across the river to find sanctuary with their son. Due to Mary's torment, it made their son irritable. So he decided to take the matters into his own hands, by meeting up with his father James Anderson when a fight broke out between them both. Where their son ended up in court due to James Anderson prosecuting his son. The fatal day came on the 6th of December. 1883, John Woods, James and Mary's nephew, went to their home to collect some clothes, as he recently moved to Oston Ferry to live with their son. When John Wood walked into the home, he walked into a physical confrontation that was happening in the kitchen. James Anderson had a knife in his hand while Mary was protecting herself. John Woods did not hesitate to run outside pleading for someone to help, but it was too late. Within moments, John Woods noticed his Aunt Mary staggering into the street. She walked as far as she could to board a ferry, but the blood coming out the gash in her neck was too much. James Anderson started yelling that it was all Mary's fault for provoking him, then he sliced his own throat with the same knife he used to kill Mary. With how much blood was on the floor, anyone would have thought James Anderson would be dead. Unfortunately for him, he recovered, which made him more angry and wished the blade was sharp enough so he could cut off his own head. It was not long before he was held at the 10-year-old Lincoln Gaol. James Anderson admitted his guilt to his brother during a visit, and admitted that he only deserved to die. The only issue that had to be resolved was, did James Anderson plot the murder? During the trial, they found that James Anderson was guilty of murder. All what is to consider is about James and Mary's reputation before this murder, as citizens from East and Oston Ferry, who were in full support of an appeal that was sent to the Home Secretary. This was ultimately rejected. An executioner was brought in from Horncastle named William Marewood, who also worked as a shopkeeper, had a notorious reputation as an executioner. He almost hung 400 men. William perfected a new way of executing prisoners known as the long drop, and finally, to William's delight, he had someone he could try it on. The 19th of February came. James Anderson wore his death suit. He was escorted to the gallows, where William Marewood placed the noose around his neck. When James dropped, he was the first man to die in Lincoln's new prison on Greetwell Road.